This three-story, 20-room mansion was built in stages over the course of a dozen years. It was the home of Major John A. Pickler, his wife Alice Alt Pickler, and their four children.
John Pickler was South Dakota's first U.S. congressman, but before that he was a territorial legislator, and he is the man who founded the town of Faulkton.
Pickler was 38 years old and well-established as an attorney and businessman when he came to Dakota Territory. He was born in Indiana but grew up in Iowa. He served in the 3rd Iowa Cavalry and saw action in an uncounted number of engagements between 1862 and the end of the war in 1865. After the war, he attended the University of Iowa, where he met his future wife, Alice Alt. Pickler went on to earn a law degree from the University of Michigan. He set up a practice in Iowa, got into state-level politics, and with his wife began raising a family. In 1882, he made a life-changing choice.
He read an article in Scribner's magazine about the Dakota land boom, and he said to his wife, "Don't you want to be a pioneer like our parents were?" And so he came out here with 13 other men and staked out their claims to homestead, and that's what he did. He picked out his spot and then built his little claim shanty and stayed in his shack. He said his floorless and roofless shack to begin with, and then he could hear the prairie wolves howling at night, and so that was his claim, and then he started building the house around that. He commissioned a couple of the bachelor men that were homesteaders to build him a house. So the house that they built around his little claim shanty is what is now the dining room and the master bedroom. And then there was a ladder upstairs for the two girls' rooms.
The Picklers had two more children and began adding rooms to their house.
Well, the first addition to the house was the kitchen in 1885.
I've always said that the interesting part about this house, everything in this house was left here by the Pickler family. They intended for this to become a museum, I'm sure.
Then in 1887, they added on to the master bedroom and made the back porch, or we call it the kitchen porch. They also added a summer kitchen because it was so hot for cooking. Then they added on to the bathroom, because in 1890 they added running water to the house.
It was hooked at one time to a reservoir on the coal wood cook stove here, and that's what heated the water. And then it went in here, and it was piped over to the sink behind me, and then to the bathroom. And then for a period of time, there was a bathroom up in the hallway upstairs.
Then they added the library building, which is a two-story hotel building that came from the town of Lafoon, becoming the library and the music room, and then some of the rooms upstairs. Well, actually, it's the boys' rooms and the guest room.
The beautiful woodwork in the music room was done by a gentleman from the town of Crespard, 14 miles away from us. He came and spent the winter living right here in the house with the Picklers. And he did all of this work put all this woodwork up in here, finished it and everything, all by hand.
John Pickler was elected to the territorial legislature in 1884 and made a name for himself as a champion of voting rights for women. A suffrage bill he sponsored passed through the legislature, but was vetoed by the governor. When South Dakota achieved statehood in 1889,
then he was elected to the United States House of Representatives from the new state of South Dakota in 1889 and served four terms.
He continued to be a strong advocate for woman suffrage, but the opposition in Washington, D.C. was somewhat more fierce than it had been in Dakota Territory.
He would speak for women's suffrage when they called him Petticoats Pickler and said he was hiding behind the skirts of his wife and daughters.
Pickler retired from politics and returned to Faulkton in 1897. He continued to work as a land inspector and lawyer until his death in 1910. Alice Alt Pickler was also politically active throughout her life, primarily in the suffrage movement. Mrs. Pickler was closely connected to national leaders of the movement, including Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Susan B. Anthony.
We know that Susan B. Anthony came and stayed here in the house several times. She described the room that she loved with the rose wallpaper upstairs. We know that she was here.
Alice Pickler lived to see women get the vote in 1919 with the passage of the 19th Amendment. She continued to live in Faulkton until her death in 1932.
Mrs. Pickler gave the house to her oldest daughter, and Lula lived here until 1956, when she fell in the kitchen and broke her hip. And then her children took her to live in Aberdeen. She lived another 10 years.
But the mansion sat vacant. The deed was passed to the Pickler's eldest granddaughter, who tried to clean things up during the 1970s.
But she had kept the house locked up and wouldn't allow the community to see it. And part of that is because of vandalism.
But then in 1987, the Pickler's granddaughter changed her mind about keeping the family home.
And she said, look, if you get a grant from the South Dakota Committee on the Humanities and you catalog all the books and papers in the house and prove to me that you're sincere, I'll give you the house to become a museum. So that's what we started doing, and I was the project director for that. We ended up with 585,000 pieces of paper. The oldest was a Civil War battlefield letter. And so in 1989, the State Archives came and picked up all of those papers then, and have been working with them ever since. So she did sign over the house to us in 1987 then, and we started working on restoration, and it's been a lot of work ever since.
Nearly the entire house has been restored. Work continues on the tower.
It was leaning. It was like 6 inches away from the house. And it was dangerously leaning. So it needed some new cement down underneath and some reinforcing in the walls.
The house's distinctive pink color is a very close match to the original color applied in 1894. The mansion is open for viewing during the summer months and hosts school tours from time to time.
Some people said, just let it go, burn it down, but there were 6 presidential inauguration invitations here in the house. I mean, who goes to 6 presidential inaugurations? It was just unbelievable, the papers and the things they did and the people they knew. And we know that Teddy Roosevelt came here and he stepped off the train and he said, well, hello, Major. So we know he knew him and we know he came back here to visit. And Susan B. Anthony stayed here at least twice. It's just amazing that these people that were involved in the national politics were coming here to Faulkton, South Dakota, out here in the middle of nowhere.